together, we make two faithful beach bums. Blessed that you have joined us here today, because we have got a story to share with you. But first, before we hit that, we want to sing a little bit and get the
jump by, shalom, to your home.
To your home.
Jump by, shalom.
Rain is coming down. Yahweh, our Father in the heavens, the great I am. He is blessing us with a band of rain that has been coming all day long. It really pays to keep those holy feasts. Woo!
Shabbat shalom.
By the condition of the world, but when Abba began to sing, everything was healed. And here's what he said that's kept us going for almost 8 years now.
Everything's going to be alright.
I decided to do something a little different than we normally do, and I told CJ that I was going to drop some questions, kind of like a TV interview, to move things along in such a way that we might be able to wrap some of this question air thing up shortly. Okay, CJ, I understand that our Heavenly Father has come to you and for you to deliver a message of warning to the United States.
This is a fact.
Why did God give you the formula 1 hour equals 77.7 days?
You know, this could take a lot of turns, but I would say the way I would answer to anybody to say why is beyond my capacity to know. But to know what he wants me to do with it is a whole different ball game. He's given me the message that I will reach out into my nation, into this land of milk and honey where I grew up too, to my brothers and my sisters, to each and every one of you, and tell you that our Father is calling us. You know, we think very highly of ourselves in these United States. Well, some of us do and some of us don't, but the point is, we have been given an enormous blessing to live on the one place on the face of the earth where there's peace and every opportunity. And we have, well, we've trashed that. We've lived unrighteously. We've done abominable things, abortion. You know, I could go on. And if it offends anyone, you know, so be it. I'm sorry. It's not me whomsoever you should worry about offending. It is your Father in the heaven. He does, however, forgive through the name and the blood of Yeshua, Jesus, our Christ. But he doesn't expect us to go, okay, well, I'll be forgiven anyway. He's expecting us to stand up and walk righteously, for this is the promised day is fast upon us. And that's what I'm believing.
Yes.
He gave the warning, so I know what's supposed to happen. It all started with that journey to heaven when he showed me truth. And now that I go forward, it's a twofold, maybe threefold situation. First and foremost, come to Yeshua today, because you don't know what day you will expire.
Yes.
But you do know, with the other layers that Father has given, you can rest assured that a mighty storm is coming upon us in this nation.
We do not know what the future holds for us.
Oh, we know that something this way comes, but it's not because God hates us. It's because God loves us. So you have to think like a parent. Do you ever spank your children for wrong behavior? God chastens those whom he loves. And if he were to let us continue in our abominable state, he wouldn't really love us. His intent is not to just crush us like a bug and leave us in our goo.
Yes.
It's to change us to righteousness, to lift us up, to climb higher, to climb the mountain spiritually. Like
CJ, I know that he has given you something that we call a preparation clock.
Yeah.
And I also understand...
The name's getting longer and longer.
And I understand within that preparation clock, there's several elements. So one of the things that I would like to strike on is, why do you think, or why did he give you 20 judgment to be part of that clock?
Judgment 20 day, the way I see it is he's talking about as far as the east to the west. Because in the beginning, when he said judgment 20, I drew a conclusion that the number 20 must mean judgment. But however, that is not correct. The number 20 means expectation, redemption, ransom, and also it's the metal silver, which Yeshua was sold out for, 30 pieces of silver. So he's saying, as far as the east to the west, are you my friend? Or are you my enemy?
Separation of the sheep from the goat.
Yes, are you in my right hand? Are you in my left hand? And on that judgment day, it's as if, I would say this, you know, when we watch the Bible movie and in the Bible, it talks about God sent those angels, angelic messengers or whatever they were, they marked people with a mark that was marked for Yahweh. And those were the ones that would be spared the trouble that was coming. Well, it's just like that. On Judgment Day, I'm believing that God is looking out of the heavens at you and me. And what he's trying to see is if we will be marked with a capital Y for Yeshua and Yahweh. Will we be marked with our Father's name and be spared the torment that comes upon this nation? Because truly, the United States has become as Sodom.
Well, CJ, I also understand that that's also part of the clock, meaning that there are certain dates that the Judgment 20 falls on.
Well, yes, there are certain dates, and there's one embedded into every single hour. We have the clock hung behind us. I'm not sure if you can see it.
But that's okay.
Where you're looking, but you can see it on our website, and that's for sure.
Yes.
It's posted there. But within every single hour, this 10-hour, 777 days... Judgment, well, it's not a judgment clock. Here's the, if I put the whole name out there, it would be...
Right, it's a preparation clock.
It would be...
With times of 20 judgment within it.
It would be Yahweh's and Yeshua's 10-hour, 777-day preparation hours, birthing pains, watch clock.
There you go. That's wonderful. That's a great. All right. So within also is the concept 40.
Yes. Within every hour, there is the concept of 40. And 40 is a little more complex than 20, because 20 is just focusing upon one day, that day to be marked. Are you with him? Or are you against him? And maybe, you get these 10 marks, and your 10 marks might be 10 points. Who knows how God will use that to establish who's with him. But what I can say about the 40 is the 40 spans the entire hour of time, the entire 77.7 days or so. Because some days have 78 days, depending on the count out. It's all part of what he's shown me, so I can't really explain it here. But the 40 is like breathing.
Right.
If we're awake or asleep, we're constantly breathing. Well, during the course of the hour, the 40 is constantly occurring. And 40 is all about testing and trial. It's about purification. It's a period within the hour, God is trying to bring us into ways that make us purified for the bride. This watch clock is for the bride of Yeshua. It's for the body of believers. It's for the church. And if you are seeking and wondering, you know, if you want to be some heads up on what's the body doing, what's the bride being called to, and what are we all going to go through, because we're all going to experience the same thing. The difference is those people who are sealed with their names in the Lamb's Book of Life, if your name has been written and sealed, then you will be spared the worst of the torment. You will be divinely protected. It does not mean you will not die for your testimony, for we have told, but this life is nothing. You can't protect the shelf life of the flesh, but you can stretch it out a few days, but one day or another it's going to go. There is one sting of death if you go to your grave as a faithful, beloved servant and devoted to God the Father and God the Son. But if you decide to wing it and run from the cost of living beneath that veil, you will have two deaths, and one of those deaths will be eternal torment in Ghana, in hell. For yes. I heard the Father both say, to hell with all of you, which wasn't cursing us, it's a meaning of a place, and the Son who buys our ticket away from that, and the courtroom who ruled to become fuel for the rest. But yet for our Savior, he stepped up and he said, I believe all negative energy can be transformed if held long enough by the hand in love. I don't know about you, Randy, but...
And he's been doing that since over 2,000 years.
2,000 years.
So now where we're at with the preparation clock is that now he's getting down into those final hours of us on the believers on this planet Earth. And the preparation clock, the very first hour, happens to fall on the starting of Feast of Trumpets.
Yeah, and you know, that's really holy and significant. And for the Christian church, most of us don't understand the significance of that. And if you don't, I would ask you to watch the long version of the DVD that we've made, because we've made every effort to explain it. But you can also research for yourself about Feast of Trumpets. But listen to this.
All of the feasts.
About all of the feasts. But there are certain feasts that are holy convocations to be kept unto the Lord for all generations. They're not Jewish feasts as we were always believing. They are for all the people of God. And we are become part of the family the day that we say we want to be protected by Yeshua. Because what you do is you walk in beneath his veil. And he is very much a Jewish man. Now, your question was, it really was taking me somewhere. Could you restate it one time? Because...
Why did the first hour start with the Feast of Trumpets?
Yes. Okay, so incredible. Because the Feast of Trumpets represents the time that a trumpet in the heavens is blown. And that trumpet in the heavens signifies either the start of a war or the coming of a king. And in our case, there's both. It will both be a war, but I don't know what it'll look like. I'm not talking about blood and guts that you and I are battling. Our Savior comes to do battle for us with a two-edged sword. He rightly divides the word, however he does that. For us, the king, I'm believing that when that real battle begins, the bride is out of here. We have been gathered up. We've been taken into a safe refuge to wait, a retreat, if you will. But a safe refuge where we wait out that big storm. But some of our guys will be coming back riding white horses right along with the Lord.
Yes.
And I hope to see my husband there wearing that white robe on that horse.
What I'd like to do is now we have something else that's very interesting, and we just came across this just recently.
I was heading right there.
Okay.
This is what we're cutting short.
Now, how does the prep clock, the preparation clock, parallel to a lot of the things that's going on right now with the tetrads and the blood moons?
Well, that's the same thing. The blood moon tetrads, is that's one word. But where I thought you were heading, and I'm going to add two more dimensions. We've got blood moon tetrads, we have comet ISON, and we have the rarest hybrid solar eclipse. The rarest hybrid solar eclipse and comet ISON, which is sort of like one sun, will be passing through our Earth's orbital plane at the same time in only a few days from now, because today is October 30th, and it passes through, they cross each other on November the 3rd. At that moment when they cross, there's a huge significance. It's as if, well, let's just say this. Comet ISON is likened unto Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And the rarest hybrid solar eclipse, they come together. It's about harvest, because also they cross over Boots. Boots is a constellation. Boots himself is likened to Yeshua of Nazareth, Jesus Christ. And he has all of the elements. It's things that you just got to research or listen to the DVD that we made.
Well, he holds a sickle.
He holds a sickle.
And a sword.
He does all the things that he both reaps, he gathers, he whisks away those that are his.
Yes.
But what I'm believing is this first pass through is going to be, there may be a great gathering for all I know.
Praise Yah.
Praise Yah, definitely. And, but I also believe it's the point of time when we become betrothed to him. He's passing through close. He actually comes almost face to face with Israel, because the way the planet will be spinning at the moment of perihelion, which is a brand new word for me, thanks to Louis Vega of Sonoma University.
Now, she's not saying that the comet is he. She's just using this as an example, ISON, because we know who Yeshua is. This is truly a comet, the timing and everything. It all deals with the star, with the heavens, and the signs and the wonders that is written in the Bible.
It's all written about. It's all in the Bible. And there was even a comet that went through back when Yeshua was born.
Yes. And that was what I was going to say is at the special time of his born, when he was born in Bethlehem, there was the star of Bethlehem.
Yes.
Well, this is very much the similar thing that's occurring with the blood moons and with alignments of the comet and all the things of how all this is lining up at the time and the season that it's lining up. This is really a great time to be alive, especially if you're a believer.
And you know what I read today is that this the occurrence of, this is really important. When Comet ISON reaches perihelion, when it makes its flip around the Earth, when it turns to go back the other way, when it makes its flip around the sun to go back the other way, it will be at that point the closest to the Earth, as far as at that moment it's facing to Israel. I may have my facts slightly off, but the point is it's facing, Israel is facing. So it becomes that these two are known as a witness. These are called the two witnesses. As far as the stars are concerned, the comet ISON being one witness and the rarest hybrid solar eclipse being the other. And I think it's hugely significant that 3 years ago the Lord said to me, solar sinking.
Yes.
And I didn't know what solar sinking was.
Now
it became complex, and I just kind of looked away from it after a while. So, but God, when you look away and it's time to come back to it, he brings you back to it. And it's a holy, beautiful thing. There was something in there I'm getting lost on.
But that's okay. CJ, what I'd like to do now is just, we got a few minutes left. What I'd like to do now is for you to give the whole point of what the preparation clock was supposed to be. What is that supposed to happen?
What this does is, Father added another layer during Tabernacles. He's shown me that this clock is now to be as imagining it as a belly womb of a woman. And we take that clock and we overlay it upon the United States of America. For it started with the word to the United States of America when he shown the two storms coming in the sky. And then Father puts this woman on her back in the sky that day. The two storms became one pregnant woman laying on her back along the southern edge of the United States map. Father put it upon me to insert the clock into her belly womb and to begin looking at this now as not simply a watch clock, because before we were simply watching the times and we knew that we were being transformed, we were being changed. But when he put the clock in there, it made it so much simpler and so much more agreeable, because we know, well, you don't know as much as I know, but for all you women out there that have had a baby, you know exactly what I'm talking about. When we're pregnant, there's really nothing, sisters, that you have to do aside from be excited, be happy, trust God.
And to know that you're having a baby.
Know that you're having a baby. Yeah, you can't miss it.
Because if you didn't know it.
Yeah, if you didn't know it. If you didn't know that these things were going to be going through, it's likened to being stretched to become, to bring forth something that's a difficult to bring out. Well, bringing a child forth into the life, it takes some effort, but not like building a house effort. It's endurance. It's the kind of effort it requires is endurance. You have to trust God. You have to be willing to sacrifice yourself for the life within you. And so what we're sacrificing is the old life. Father's really peeling off what the Bible calls the old man. Well, for women, that's kind of a hard thing, as I'm sure it's hard for you guys to drink in this whole pregnancy thing and the wedding. But God, he's an equal opportunity employer here. He's making all things right and making it balance. So the last trimester of pregnancy is the most difficult, the 7th and 8th and 9th months. Well, right now, we're in the 6th month. 6 hours,
and
6
think
months.
Think about all of the things that are going on in the world right now, particularly around Israel. And all of the things that's happening to you personally and in your community.
Yeah.
Think about all of the things that's going on. Things seem to be ramping up.
And they are. And what God wants you to know is not to, don't be distressed about it. The Bible foretells these things that will happen. And Jesus himself tells us, but don't be worried at that point. Because these things must happen. These things will happen before you are called up to deliver your testimony. And many of you will be killed for your testimony, but it's no big thing. Go. He said during Tabernacles this year, he said, arise in glory. He's calling me, you, and all of us to stand up and walk in the light, to stand up and be the bride, to stand up and be the light. Let your light shine. Because what we're trying to do is not intimidate people. We are, with every breath that we have, trying to bring aboard as many as will come. I don't know if you know this, but the Bible literally tells you, each of us as believers, that we have been ordained. Not just your preacher is ordained to preach the gospel, but everyone who believes in Yeshua as the Christ, Jesus as the Messiah, everyone who believes that, the Son of God, receiving that blood and that name unto yourself that keeps you from eternal torment and even protects you from much that will come upon this earth. Through that experience, God just, he's strengthening you to say, I can do this. Did you ever doubt that you could make it while you were pregnant? Well, you might have wished you could get it over with. We all hoped that the doctor would induce us. I can remember going to doctor's appointments, and I was hoping, praying with my whole heart, oh, please, 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 induce me today. But the call wasn't mine. The call was the physician's. And we, you and I, we have a great physician, and he is the just-in-time inventory specialist of forever. And he knows exactly when we are fully ripe and when thumbs are fully ready to bring forth the fruit of my womb, to bring forth the fruit of your womb and your womb. And you know what? He does not want us miscarrying. the fruit. If you sell your birthright for a cup of soup, because truly we've never known true hunger in this nation, but I'm believing those times are coming, because what I'm saying is that God's stretching us.
Yes.
We trust Him even for manna from heaven. But you don't just sit back. He's telling you to prepare right now like Joseph did when Egypt was facing some
CJ,
times.
Today is October the 30th.
Mm-hmm.
Tomorrow is October the 31st.
Oh, don't. Please
okay.
don't.
Well, we got to realize that October the 31st is in
judgment
the sixth
day.
Hour, and that's Judgment Day. Okay,
please
so people
make a righteous
realize
choice.
What times, what things are going to be going on. Then November the 1st, I understand that there's going to be things happening that day. They're announcing that's a change in the food stamp program. Okay, so I want everybody to realize that these things are ramping up. Things are happening in our government. Things are happening in society. And so it's please remember that God is preparing us. That's why we're here today talking to you guys. To let you find yourself and become, if you're a believer, more of a believer. If
walk
you're,
it
if,
out. Don't just talk
yes,
about it.
Show
just
your fruits.
Because that's what he says. In the Christian church, it's traditional. We say, well, it's not by works. It says that if there aren't works, then we're really dead. We don't want to, the life within us cannot be dead. The church should be the one doing good things. If we see a world around us that does not look good, that means the church, you and I, the body of believers, is not doing what the Lord has called us to do. We should not be sitting back talking about all the bad stuff going on, but we should be upright, going forward, singing, dancing, praising, making a joyful noise unto the Lord, and serving other people and loving them. By that love and by that service,
yeah.
you bring people
I mean,
aboard.
Not to deny the fact that things are bad going to happen. The thing is that you can say, everything's going to be all right. Everything's going to be okay. All we have to do is put our hands together.
And one thing on that, I'm glad you brought that back around. You know, in the 60s, we were very much a part of the hippie generation and the peace and the love and the happiness. And it's deep in my heart, always will be. But one thing God has shown me is that our earth ways of peace, love, and happiness, our earth ways of everything being all right and being okay by putting our hands together, a lot of times we miss the spiritual dimension. And God's telling us it's time to rebuild the temple. And I don't mean that stone brick temple, even though that will be rebuilt. And I don't mean to make light of it. I'm saying that God is telling you and me, those of us who believe, that it's time to rebuild the temple, body, mind, and soul. It is expressed through the fruit of how we serve
yes.
and love other people. If you don't like what your neighbors or friends or president or someone else is doing, don't badmouth them. We are to pray well for all people, no matter what. So lift, if you believe in the power of prayer, and if you don't, you're missing it, because it's stronger than nuclear weapons and atomic bombs. Pray! Woo! I love it when the music is going.
Shabbat
shalom
to your home. Shabbat shalom to your home.
Brothers and sisters, we truly pray that you will begin the search for your Father so that you will not have to run in fear when these days start to happen. For truly they are coming fast as a thief in the night. And those of us who are wrapped and made in the blood and in the heart, the home of our Father in the heavens, we will not have to fear, but we be strong and confident, courageous, just like He told to Joshua in the Bible.
Shabbat shalom to your home. Shabbat shalom to your home. All right, everybody. God bless you all. We love you all. And peace and shalom.
Peace, baby. We love you. I was cool, man.